episode 37 of the Optic Podcast and also episode 1 of the COVID Free Podcast.
Hell yeah, we're good.
Hell yeah.
I'm strictly a fill main right here. Like, yo, we need one. Like, Dill's out, Seth's out. Like, Brandon, you're in. I'm like, bet, I'll fill.
I'm the third string. I'm second string.
Like, yo, shit, Seth and Dill are out. So, like,
so is Brandon up? Or
I guess we'll take Brandon. I mean, might as well.
All right, you guys, you guys have to be honest. Since, like, they won't. There's no way Dylan or Seth will ever get wind of this. Like, has their performance in scrims gone down? On the vid.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, it's been trolling.
I mean, I don't even blame them.
I mean, I don't blame them either. They can't talk to people.
Yeah, they sound like, well,
they get noticeably better every day.
Yeah. I assume Activision is developing an anti-cheat. Probably takes time, but maybe now they're going to pay to use another until it's done. Probably something like that. Hey, Maven, they're doing it now because everybody's moving. Everybody's fucking dropping it, going to Apex and shit. But I am in agreement that it probably is very, very difficult to make an anti-cheat. It probably is. But I find it weird that all of a sudden it's coming out of the woodworks when people have been complaining about this shit for months, and now Warzone's dying. You know, the pressure's helping them move it along, for sure. What's going on, though, Maven? You handsome bastard? What's going on, you good-looking motherfucker? How you feeling, my guy? Grimothy, thank you so much for the 6 months, bro. I appreciate you coming in.
Yeah, you can tell.
Appreciate you, Grimothy. Much
love,
bro.
But I was talking about, like,
you're
in
a fucking
real life.
Grimothy,
like,
you're a legend.
Have to stay away from them and stuff.
Real quick, before we start this, Grimothy, you're a fucking legend, by the way. You know that? You're a fucking legend. Let's get into the video.
I meant, like,
yeah. For Seth, it's easy. He's in, like, a mansion.
That's
yeah,
true.
For Dale, it's a little harder.
He's in a one-bedroom apartment.
Pretty sure Sam's got COVID.
Whose idea was it to throw these four morons on the desk? Because it was a fantastic idea.
It's inevitable. It's for sure inevitable.
Oh, wait, can Seth talk to Buzz and stuff?
That's got a second house. That is.
He's got a guest house. The guy got to stay
in his other house.
He's quarantining in his guest house.
Sam's in the trenches.
She's sleeping on the couch, up, just shivering.
She's gaming on, like, the TV in the living room. Like, got, like, fucking horrible shit. Delay. Play on Wi-Fi.
That is so
no, you didn't miss the announcement label. That's going to be during the flank, brother.
Like, two massive games. Just losing your shit.
Oh shit. Oh man.
Seth's reaction to probably, like, when they told him, like, you're positive. Dude, it was probably hilarious.
Out of all of them. Out of all of them.
Yeah. I don't mean to laugh, but, like, I know
Seth,
it was so funny. He's probably like, wait, what?
He's here. No, Seth knew he had it. Knew he had it. Like, and me and him were taking, we were like, me and him went, and his thing was, like, right after ours, so we see him pull up to the parking lot, but at that point, he already knew that he had it, right? Yeah. Like, he knew that he had it, yeah. And we just see him walking up to the door. He doesn't know that we're in the parking lot, and he looks so funny. He's just, like, waddling to the door, like he looked like he had it. He looked like he had it.
He was like, man, I know this shit's about to be positive. Yeah. Dude,
no, that was good. Comedy, bro.
You had the walk of shame, for sure.
The fact that he got it, it's not funny.
It's not funny.
It's kind of scary how but fast, like, it bounced around from everyone. That's what's creepy.
I don't, like, know.
Boom,
who,
boom, boom, boom. Just, yeah, a bunch of pros. Dude,
wait, like, has anybody
the responsible
else,
ones. Yeah.
Has anybody else come forward and said,
yo, Chad, no bullshit. That is pretty scary. It's pretty scary how when one person gets it, a bunch of people get it, like, that fast. It's like a chain fucking reaction, you know? It's like this COVID shit, it's fucking nuts. And then you got Matt and Bruce saying, you know, at least we're the responsible ones.
Has anybody the responsible else, ones.
Yeah. Has anybody else come forward and say they have it besides those two?
Yeah, I don't know if, like, I share that out, forward. But yeah, a lot of pros have it.
A lot of pros.
Really? A lot of pros. Not a lot. That's like probably like 8.
Yeah, yeah.
Not to say like, oh, now is the best time. But when they did get it was probably
it's better than having getting it 3 days from now.
Exactly. Yeah. Or 3 days after when they did get it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That shit's champs around the corner.
Because I mean, apparently everything's still on for champs. Which I'm surprised everything's still on, but I think in the next, like, 2 days we'll know more.
Wait.
Yeah, dude.
Like a pinball machine.
No, yeah.
I mean, I'm kind of, I don't know. See, I'm not really surprised that it's going on still. I'm not, because a lot of money was probably pumped into it. A lot of fans already bought tickets, right? The tickets are already sold. Everybody's booking flights. Everything's already planned. And everything just happened so quick. So, I don't think they're going to shut it down, but they're going to have to take precaution. They're going to have to do certain things to make sure everybody's good. You know what I'm saying?
Literally.
It does bounce, bro. The show, like, the show must go on, chat.
So it's like, that's it. That's how it works.
Dude, the fact, like, Seth might be the most paranoid person I've ever met in my entire life. It is
surprising, yeah. Out of works us four, out. Like, that's got it. Like, you would think out. Seth would be the last.
Yeah.
He takes all precautions.
Yeah, the way that everyone was in the podcast before, they were like, the fans cannot come up.
Yeah, Seth was like, I'm not talking to anybody.
He turns out Seth's the man who puts the music like...
Yeah, I'm wearing two masks, fuck that.
I can't talk to any of you guys.
So just the cloud music in the back.
It's so annoying for Seth.
That's really fucked up, but also very funny.
Feel better, man.
But they are but they are feeling better. They're getting better throughout scrims
and
stuff.
Yeah. The first couple of days they sounded rough. I was like, yo, like, are we gonna make it?
Dill is like handling it a little better than Seth. Did they bring a milkshake? Can I have that? I'm not eating a melted milkshake later.
That's good. Yeah, that's a good call.
That's like 40
call.
Minutes. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, like, see how Steph put it in the fridge.
This guy, Matt's getting
that's actually a good play,
bro.
But I like it now.
So Hex is, let's look at the topics for today. Hex is selling his art for the first. You know, if Hex was here, he'd crumple up paper and throw it away. So, yeah, good luck. Good luck on your art selling, Hex.
Yeah.
But he looks like he's having fun with that. Creator's moving away from Warzone.
Damn, that's kind of tragic.
Yeah, Chick-fil-A. That's really bad
timing. That's a big L.
That's really bad timing for you guys.
Looks so
good. Shout out Chick-fil-A, let us know.
I just got completely distracted from the topic. All my attention is on the milkshake now.
Chick-fil-A, let us know.
You didn't order me one? We didn't even think of that.
I'm Catholic. You can cut that.
I think creators moving away from Warzone is pretty bad timing for all the CDL pros that were all expecting to go to Warzone after champs.
Yeah.
But now you guys are all going to play Valorant?
I mean,
it looks like
I'm still going to play Warzone, but it's just like, just sucks though. Like, it's just a big L for the scene. Like, Nick Merckx, for example. Like,
yeah.
I saw him say that he was going to switch. This guy averages like, what, 70K?
That's a big huge L.
His little group just like, just pulls viewers.
They
bro, I think it was Zinni who said it, but Nick Merckx streams to 3 Madison Square Gardens every day. Every day, this guy's filling out Madison Square Garden times 3 in his fucking chat. Now, I don't know about you guys, but that's a lot of fucking people, bro. That's a lot of people. That's nuts. That's fucking nuts. And I'm curious, because I don't know about you guys, but Nick Merckx and his whole little crew and shit, and I'll move my cam up a little bit. Nick Merckx and his whole little crew and shit, these guys are on Apex now, and they're having a blast. These guys are on every day. Nicola's putting in like 13-hour streams. I've never seen Nick Merckx grind like this. They're leveling up. They're trying to get the fucking... yeah, he went from fucking 60K to 55K. He took a big hit. A big hit, you know?
All switched.
That's like 100K with like all their group combined?
No, that's like four like huge people just leaving. Him and Tim and like...
Him, Tim, Cloak, Jack, they all left. And they all left.
It hurts all.
That sucks.
Yeah, so now the top Warzone, you know, the top Warzone streamers are, you know, back to it's like... Mutex Huskers.
Was that thing real? Like, welcome season.
And speaking of them, chat, Mutex Huskers, Aiden, all the guys who are strictly Warzone, which is why I didn't want to fall into that trap. How are they doing? Are their streams taking a hit because of this? Are their streams taking hits because their viewers come from Warzone? You know, everybody wants to see them play Warzone, but when they stream other stuff. Are they okay? TP's doing good? Yeah, Teep's doing fucking phenomenal. I'm happy for the guy. They're still doing good. Aiden is playing Apex. So for the most part, everybody's still doing good. Typically, the people left playing Warzone do better. Oh, really? When the big people dip? Okay, so I guess that's like the main thing. If the big people dip, then everybody else... Okay, I understand. I get what you're saying. Okay. It's like the big people run the show. Yes, because some still want to watch Warzone. I think a little hit, of course. It's got to take a little bit of a hit. They definitely got to take it. Because there's definitely just like a lot of Warzone fans that were watching their streams. But that was like the main worry for me, maybe in like getting into like Warzone. Like people were telling me to play Warzone every day. I didn't want to be a Warzone streamer. Like I want to do like everything, you know? Like I would love to hop on Warzone now and then. Like I was playing Warzone all the time. But, you know, I would always like to play other games and keep it fresh, you know? Always play new games, always do different things and just, you know. Unfortunately, I love to play the Path of Exile. Hey, that sounds kind of fucking fire, though, Maven. I don't know. I never played that shit. And most of my viewers leave, laugh my ass off. Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. Like, bro, Maven, you're a funny guy. I would watch you play that. Like, I'd watch you play anything, which is why that's, like, the right... That's, like, the road I want to get into, you know? But it's scary for Warzone streamers who just have done nothing but fucking play Warzone, you know? Because now that Warzone's going down the shit, I hope none of them are taking too much of a hit. But from the sound of it... they follow the big streamers over at Apex, and everybody's doing well. So,
you're talking about that's good. That's
really cool. I love you too, Maven.
It says hackers welcome or something.
Yeah,
oh, I didn't see that.
Because I saw Jack like replied to someone's tweet that tweeted it, and I was like, what the fuck?
It looked
kind of
real.
That one, I'm like, it did. Like,
they got you.
They're insane if they did some shit like that. Like,
nah, I'd tip that. They'd be like, now we don't fuck with y'all.
Yeah, hell yeah. Now like, it's
keep
real.
Bitching. Keep bitching. We're not changing shit.
I get it though. Like they just we were watching this Fortnite the Ariana Grande concert, remember? And we're like, bro, Epic's doing this for Fortnite, and then we can't even get an anti-cheat for our game. They have a full-on concert.
I didn't watch it, but I saw that it was
and it looks so dope.
We were watching that shit from Ninja's Movie, bro.
It looks so dope.
Dude, if I was like a Fortnite kid and I had that, I'd be dumb hype.
Yeah, it's an experience.
I had chills the whole time, bro. Like the shit they were doing, I was like, this is so cool.
It is sick.
Yeah,
it
dude.
Dope. Like I was like, this is just so cool.
I watched the Marshmallow one was cool, but then they went crazy with the Travis Scott one.
Yeah, I watched the Travis one. Travis one's really good too.
And then I knew they were gonna like crush. Actually, I watched the whole Star Wars one. That shit.
There was a Star Wars one? You see, like, bro, they're going above and beyond.
Bro, they go above and beyond.
Yeah.
For like these things, like
the fact that it's in game.
The fact that it's live. Like,
yeah.
There's no fuck ups. You know what I'm saying? Like they have all the people like ready for that. Their servers probably explode for that shit.
Bro, the fact
I don't play Fortnite, still watch that shit.
The fact there hasn't been like a Post Malone concert in stadium, like that would be like the perfect place. Yeah, like in Warzone. Stadium. You know what I mean? It's literally a stadium. Like something like sick. That. Like
it just gets like they just don't give a
that'd
fuck.
Be sick.
Let's just be honest. They just
I don't think
fuck.
I just don't think they care.
They
I really
don't.
They don't give a fuck.
Just one. Like anti, they're watching it. Like damn, that sucks for them. Like shit. Like maybe next year we'll think about it. Like we'll think about it.
You think they have like Husker stream up like at their offices and shit, and right? And like they're watching him, right? Like he's on like a big screen. Or like, just like the HQ, right? And they're walking by and people can run to him. What do you think they think when like they walk by and like, damn, you decided to be a hacker? That sucks. He's on like 30? Man, that sucks. It's like, don't change it at all.
Yeah, I don't think.
They're probably just like, I mean, that's what comes with making a game, right? Like,
you know, yeah, probably.
It's
always gonna be those guys. Yep.
It can't happen. Yeah, downtown is filled with that.
It's gonna happen. Yeah. It's gonna happen.
He knew what he was doing.
No, there's like one guy that's like, should we fix that? And they're like, shut the fuck.
You know how much money that's gonna be?
I said decaf.
Like, what?
Motherfucker.
That's probably exactly what it's like.
Yeah, 100%.
That one guy that's like, yeah, we should probably do something about this. And then everyone's like, what the fuck? What's wrong with this guy?
Jerry, shut the fuck up.
Yeah, it's good though.
Well, yeah, champs is in a week. Do you think you guys' like scrim schedule is the same as everybody else that's how many teams do you think are affected by this whole like COVID thing?
At least three? Yeah. I don't think Minnesota is. They're all vaxxed.
Yeah, vaxxed.
They're vaxxed.
They're all vaxxed.
They're vaxxed.
Including their coach.
I tip that major.
Yeah.
I tip a lot of things about major. Yeah, you know what he said? That was fucking comedy. You got to tell it again, bro. I said it last podcast. But I know you're going to cry.
What?
Bro, he was like, after Minnesota won, he's like, you know what's crazy about attach? And I was like, what? He's like, he's always guaranteed a piece of the pie.
Every year, he's guaranteed a slice. It doesn't matter if it's a big one or a small one. Last year, for example,
it's so true.
You won Mono Whip for the home series. That's a small piece
it's
of the
like
pie.
It's like ever since Ghost,
he's guaranteed a slice.
He's gonna get one.
It might not be big. It might be a small piece. But he's getting
the crumb.
He's catching a slice that year. You know what I'm saying? It might be nothing all year and then champs, but he's gonna get a piece.
But he's getting artillery 1v3. Like he's getting himself a slice.
He's gonna find a way.
You know what I'm saying? He's getting himself a slice.
I gotta tip that.
I tip that too.
He's such a nice dude.
Shout out to Touch.
Very nice guy.
That's funny.
how it affected, man, it's the same. They're just asking the same questions in multiple different ways. You're rich and you see what I mean? Rich and lonely drop.
What the fuck? It's just like rephrase the question.
You really want a controversial statement out of it?
It took the need to fill the essay to get like a certain word count.
the next, if you got for those that don't see, the next topic is COVID outbreak amongst COD pros. The same thing we've been talking about for the past 25 minutes. The RNL drop.
That was dope.
Oh yeah.
How did that go?
That design was heat, especially the comic book one with the white
that
one.
When I saw that one, I was so like, fire. Yo, Aaron's
Rich and Lonely's killing
when he came
it,
out
bro.
That one, I was like,
yeah, shout out to Aaron on that.
Yeah, yeah.
That one was fire. He must have been sitting on it, but he must have had it.
I might need to do a Rich and Lonely collab with my man. Like, what do you guys think?
Yo, I remember when Marcus DM'd me, he was like, I think we're going to do this. What do you think of this? I was like, yeah, we're
going to
do that. I'm down for that.
That shit was fire. But yeah, it went well.
Would you
it
guys fuck with a Rich and Lonely? How do you collab? Figure would out? You, guys you, buy
just, it? You just like go through all your homies and you're like, who haven't I collabed with yet? And that's who you go with next? Or
well,
like,
I see sometimes like I'll like go through and I'll just see people tweeting me randomly.
Yeah.
And like
yeah.
his, well, Bet, I usually decide by when people send me ideas for someone like, yo, we need to see that Batman. Or,
yeah. Like, that's, you get what I'm that's saying? That's what I was like, thinking. Okay. Like, do you come up with the designs and you're like, holy shit, like a Batman thing would be dope for Bruce,
well,
and then you go
I didn't know at first, but Aaron brought that up to me, like Bruce? The whole but he didn't do like Batman, he did like I forgot what he was scared or something about the he didn't want to get copyrighted
he
did like Bruce Wayne,
yeah, like I wasn't even thinking I was thinking of Dashy the whole time, but I forgot his name Bruce,
yeah,
and I was like, oh okay, I get it where they're coming from.
So it
was good, it went well.
That is super dope. Who you got in the tank? Who do you think is coming next for a collab? Did the rapper shit ever work out or no?
They you always know, just they cap. Like they, it's not that I get it. They're probably busy, but like I'm not just gonna keep like.
Yeah, you
at
can't.
Some point,
you can't
like I might be doing
DMs.
You a favor a little bit. So like I'm not gonna dick ride you to do you a favor.
Because I've talked about Bose already. I talked to Aaron and I talked to Bose about linking up and doing something. It's just a matter of like getting everything together and getting the right shit and making sure it also looks good and making sure that I'm able to do it. Cause you know, like with certain contracts and stuff too, like when it comes to merch, like that's also stuff that's written up in a contract. I want to make sure I'm not crossing any, stepping on anybody's toes or stuff like that, but would definitely like to do a Rich and Lonely job with Bose and Aaron and all those guys, you know? So we'll see. We'll see moving forward.
That's so true.
Like,
it's just like, hey, do you want to make money? Do you want to make money?
Yeah, like, okay, you don't need it. My bad. I get it. You're rich.
I'm not going to dick ride you to do you a favor.
Yo, please, thank you for this one, bro.
Dude, I remember, like, it's happened
that.
With, like, three rappers.
Yeah, dude,
you've come
up
to me and you're like, dude, he responded. Like,
look at
this
Twitter,
shit.
Bro. And I'm not going to dick ride you to do you a favor.
I'm not going to dick ride you to do you.
Because they always hit you back up and they're like, yeah, hell yeah, let's do it.
Let's lock in.
And then you're like, okay, here's what we're doing. And then it's
and
just
no response.
Crickets.
Just ghost. Like, okay.
That's what it's like texting like Seth, just so people know. If people don't know what
it's like
texting Seth.
We're going to tonight, right?
And it's no response.
Maybe for you. No, Seth responds to me.
Well, I mean, that's a little different.
Yeah. You are half of the T2P after all.
He has to respond.
Yo, are you the T or the P?
Oh, my bad, go ahead.
I'm the P, the pipe.
Oh. Isn't that, yeah.
That's kind of beta, no?
No, he's T, he's tiny.
I love how you thought that out.
You've
tiny
thought this before.
Boy,
that
was like,
that
would
mean
it
was
before.
But that would mean it was
pound,
tiny
though.
To pipe. Tiny to pipe is the new
mm-mm.
time to. What is time to pipe? Where did that come from?
Yeah, where did that come from? I need to know, because this
yeah,
is stuck for years
from?
Now.
It's just for, you guys just sent me back to like 2015 Twitch chat or some
yeah,
shit.
Yeah,
what the
yeah.
fuck?
I don't understand. Does nobody know where time to pound came from? I don't know. Do you guys know?
What was that?
He's just like, I actually never knew.
But how
you never
it,
told me that.
Yeah, you never told me either.
It was my shit with one of my friends from like back in the Halo days, and Seth just rode my shit.
You just started saying it.
Yeah. I started saying it.
I feel that.
I started saying it.
He called.
And I threw my clan tag, and I got on the next day, Seth had it in his, and I was like,
just into it?
We were screaming, right? We were screaming. The next day, I come in, I'm like, I bet. He's like, you fuck with it? He's like, yeah, I fuck with it. I was like, all right, why? Why you fuck with it? Because it doesn't even make any sense. Like, it is, you know what I'm saying? It's like
yeah,
such
yeah.
a trolly like little thing.
Remember this the shirt?
The sweatshirt? I kind of, I dead ass want one.
Are they out? They always talk about it. They hated it.
I know they hated it. That's why I want one so
yeah,
bad.
Wait, they never came, like, they never even.
Oh,
thought,
they never, oh,
they
never
I
got
thought
printed?
They came out and then they were like,
Oh, they got printed.
They did get printed?
Yeah, they got printed.
Oh, I want one.
What are you talking about?
The time to pound.
You guys came out with merch?
Get you freed.
Yeah. It's limited time.
I remember Aaron texted me. He was like, bro, everybody's so mad at me right now. He was like, but someone said put time to pound on a shirt, so I did, and now I'm the bad guy.
That's exactly
that's how this works.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. Was it literally Aaron. Just that?
Yeah, I'd like to move on. I'd really like to move on.
Okay, but if anybody has one of those sweatshirts, hit me up. I'll buy it from you. We have some? Never mind. I'm not buying it from you. We have some. all right, let's get to one of the questions. What is the nastiest thing you've ever done in game that went under the radar and didn't get picked up by broadcast?
This one's kind of easy for
me. Pull it up, Matt. Pull my Twitter right now.
Yeah.
The AW one. Pull my Twitter, Matt. Nah, the AW.
Yeah, pull my Twitter. You guys got to watch this. Pull my Twitter.
This is
the
creep.
I tweeted it recently. Go to my Twitter.
I'm going to guess this. This is probably the best clip. In like,
this is one of the sickest clips of all time.
In COD for sure.
Okay. Just scroll, just keep going down. Actually, you could open that real quick.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. It's
good now. Go.
What are you doing?
Go down. Faster. You'll see it. Faster.
Even faster.
Yo, make sure to get a read in the chat.
No, it was a retweet. I don't think it'll be on this.
No.
It was a retweet.
It was a quote tweet.
Yeah, it was. Just go to my tweets. Yeah. I don't tweet that much. It should be here somewhere. It's right there.
There.
Open this, full screen this, full screen this.
This is a tippable full screen ace. I will tip that. This is a tippable ace.
This is, like, stupid.
If they were spectating.
Look at the kill feed.
One snipe, two. And then three
just
piece.
Hiss on that three. Guy.
And then jetpack.
Oh, my God.
Hiss on that guy. And then one snipe. Hiss on that guy.
It's a four piece.
Look at them. Look at them. I mean, he just no scope, man.
It's a cool shit.
I don't know.
Dude.
Yo, if
rewind it one more time.
Oh, God, if I was next to you and saw that, I would have been like.
I was so mad. I was on the screen.
Yo, he's that's probably the best.
I'm seeing school steps. I'm like, chow me. I'm staying on the open school steps.
Like, in between this kill.
Right, you know what's crazy about this round, too? Is it's 5-4. Like, this is to go to round 11. And Formal's running up the middle of the map with a fucking sniper rifle. Second off. Bro, no, it sucks. Is this has happened to me before too? Where like I'm like, yo, I did some crazy shit, and then you go back and watch it, and they miss it every time, bro. It happens all the fucking time. It happened to me like 20 times. No bullshit. It happens to every player a bunch of times where they feel like they did something crazy, and then next thing you know, it's gone. They didn't watch it. But I mean, what are you gonna do? That's why we should have every POV being recorded, though. You know what I'm saying? Hey, you know how like different esports have every POV being recorded and you can tune into everybody's POV and shit? How dope would it be if everybody's POV was recorded? Because even if something was missed, it can be shown in like a replay or something. My bang got in way better now with OBS team versus when I had to do it while casting. Yeah. Well, that too. That's actually fucking crazy. That Maven had a fucking control everything while also that shit's hard as fuck. That's not easy.
Oh, and then last
no, dude, the fact you killed him,
that was gross.
Stupid. This guy got shit on.
They all got shit on. Yeah. That was one of the sickest clips of all time. No bullshit.
That was nasty.
Just, if it was on my, if it was on my people the whole time, people would be like, holy shit. Because no, the third shot was disgusting,
dude. If that there's so many clips like that, that it's like if it was on a person's POV, like imagine if your PAX three-piece wasn't on your POV. The kill feed was going so crazy, you might not even have noticed that you got a three-piece.
Yeah.
You know
that
what I mean?
Oh, yeah. That like, happens all the time.
Because, like, I think one or two of them were trades, you know what I mean? And so it's like...
That happens a lot.
It's like there are so many instances where...
So many series that weren't streamed, like... You have like a random mixy ass side station match, like, Saturday night.
Hell yeah.
Like, someone could go off that series, you know what I'm saying? And they can be like, trust, that was frying. Dude. It was like streamed with the one. What is that show called? The live streaming, like with your phone. If like one was Periscope. Yeah. It'd be a Periscope series.
The Periscope series were crazy.
Yeah those series were so hype.
Yeah. Do you remember? Were you that? Were you at? You were at UMG Philly. You were playing on like Fear or something, right?
Mm-hmm.
Fear, do you remember the TK versus Envy side station match?
Who remembers that Team
tournament?
Fear, bro?
Yeah,
who
but
remembers?
It wasn't. That was like a Sunday morning, so I wasn't actually at the venue.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
It was like, they were yelling.
It was like for like top six or some shit.
Or no, Nezzo was hype, right?
Nezzo,
it was the Nezzo shit. Yeah,
that shit was. That was my first event ever, and so I thought side stations were always like that.
They kind of were. They were really ratchet, Side station matches?
Yeah.
There was hella shit talk.
They were, but I was talking about like the actual game. I think it went like, I mean, it wasn't hard point, but I think it was like 8-7 blitz and then like super close dom. Like, it was like really close matches and went all the way to game 5. Like
COD was lit,
like,
bro.
Like, back then, like Dom, crazy. Dom was
COD
like,
was so lit back then,
you play one half and the game would end and then you play another half, remember? So like, there'd be like a hella shit talk in between. You'd be up like 16 points or something. That was like kind of big at the time.
blown out the first side.
Yeah, like an octane. It, yeah, you just put like, him in a trap.
Exactly.
Like, yeah, we're at 40. Yeah, good luck. I can shit talk. Like, we're good.
True,
yeah. Just got to go off the next side and the map ended.
And it had like a 90 second match time, remember?
Yeah.
As the game was starting, it'd be like 90 seconds. You'd be like, all right, bet. I'm just going to wait for a while. All right, let's go. Come on.
Yeah.
Dude, that shit was annoying.
It's annoying. Dude, I forgot about that. What about you, Bruce?
Nastiest, bro. This one's easy for me.
Your entire World War II?
Yeah. I'm not even like the first event in World War II when I dropped 20 game five. I wished like that whole map was just broadcast.
Yeah, that's typical.
20?
Yeah, when I tied Krim's record.
That's typical.
And then the last round, we were up 5-4. And then the last round, I had 18 kills. And then I sniped.
Did you debate like going 5-5 just to get an extra round? You debated it. I know you. Yeah, I know you thought like wouldn't be that bad. Yeah, you guys are rushing.
I was more upset. Yo, honestly, just chill. He's weak.
Yo, rush that
he's
shit.
One shot, trust.
I got
shit, he's not one shot. All right, whatever. Yo, five. Yeah, I got streaks. Like, whatever. Nah, but I remember the 5-4 and I had 18 and then I got two snipes and then it was like two, like one was off like the cabin wall heady, which is like the god heady at the time on fours. Yeah. And the other one,
heady.
And that quick scope fell and then it was on an open bracket station and there's people behind me going, oh, I was like, damn, they're gassed. Like the 15 people watching.
Yeah,
like,
that's how you
shit. I was like, damn, I went to a stream though. I want to watch it back. Too.
That's
like
crazy.
People behind you getting the reaction.
Yeah.
And you don't have you don't have the sound canceling. So you have like the normal Astro. So you just
like, back then, like you could hear
when they're around, they're like, yo, that was nasty. That was nasty.
It just smells.
I was like, yo,
too.
Yo, but you guys want to go beat this round?
Like, oh, yeah, you could.
Everyone's like, yo, this guy's good, bro.
I remember everybody around side stations just being like, damn, it stinks over here.
This guy, Bruce, felt like a man.
Like, acting all cool about it.
That's comedy.
I used to love that shit, bro. I remember my first Halo event that I went pro at Dallas 2011. Like, I was known as an online kid, right? And we're playing on feature station, we made a 3M bracket, and back then, if you made a 3M bracket, you play the pool play matches, and you play a bunch of pro teams, right? Four of them. So, our first match was, against, FB or some shit. And FB at the time was, fresh off a Nats win. Like, they were, FB. You know what I'm saying? And, we were playing feature station, and a hell of pros behind me. Just, me specifically, because they wanted to see if, I was an online kid, right? And I'm shitting on FB. And I'm like, you guys peep that shit? I turn around and shit. I'm just like, yeah, you like what you see? Yeah, you missed out. And just thinking to myself, this is going to be so sick. Like, if I didn't have that match specifically, I would have just been, a different player.
Wait, that's what happened to me too. My first event, everyone thought I was a boarder. So I remember at Anaheim and IW, everyone just bro. This guy's cheating, right? And then I remember a hell of people were behind me nah, this kid's just gonna turn. And I was like, yeah, shit. I'm like, because I'm on 7-7, just turn, just FTLing everyone and shit. Basically dad, basically Jet. Pre-Jet.
Yeah, sure.
I'm not giving
bro,
any
people,
like
bro, I remember that fucking Selim and Dashi. Everybody thought they were keyboarding. Bro, I'm pretty sure Selim 100% got banned from Money 8s. Like, people wouldn't put him in Pro 8s. They thought he was cheating. They thought he was on the fucking keyboard. Yo, we got Dark Rayug coming in hot with a tier 1 sub. Yo, Dark, welcome to the family, bro. And Quavo Nova, thank you for the gifted sub, my guy. Appreciate you guys helping the family grow, man.
You know what I'm saying?
I didn't know if Dylan would. When Dylan was coming up and everybody knew he was boarding, I didn't know who he was, but I did know the name Illy, and everyone thought he boarded.
Yeah.
Everyone in my circle.
That whole circle was just sketch.
Yeah,
Cell?
Me, Cell, and they're
it's just a little sketchy.
All three of us, they were like, these guys are boarding for
oh
sure.
Oh my God. Yeah. Just playing those people.
Some of y'all were boarding.
Potentially.
No, y'all just have like a fucking.
I didn't know Dylan used
to cheat. I know a lot of SND scene kids that have boarded.
Killer's the one that told me about Envoy. He's like, what? That bull's on Optic? He used to cheat.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
He's like, what?
These fools are getting butts.
He used to cheat.
Yeah. No small sauce for that thing. He's like, wait, is that Optic?
Yeah, he's like, what? Probably dragging a thing, just mind blown. He's like, huh?
Disgusted at that.
I should have cheated. Right? You know what I'm saying? I was probably thinking about that shit.
He used to cheat.
That was pretty scummy back then, I'm not gonna lie.
Dill burned every bridge in his come up. All the MPs don't fuck with Dill.
The only way for Dill was up. That was the only way.
I'm on Optic now. It all worked out for the ones that deserve it. Just a cheat.
Wait, you ended up, you won. I'm assuming you won the S&D that you dropped 20 on, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank God.
Because that would have been.
I dropped 20 for the L?
This had to have happened before.
Imagine lose your bracket.
I don't think it's.
Peace.
On land?
I'm off the team. Peace. Yeah.
Dude, I wish that match was streamed. That was the best we've ever played, from map 1 to map 5. Because in the second map, I had, in the second SA, I had 17.
On the London. 37 in two SMEs? Yeah.
Jorge, I'm 37 kills in two SMEs.
I can't fact check this, so I'm just going to tip
damn,
it.
Damn.
Almost 40 in two SMEs.
I wish it was streamed at 35.
Dropped like 160.
Damn, I had like 40 in SMEs. It was weird. At map 1, I had like 58. For, I don't know. It was weird.
I wish it was streamed so you guys could see it.
I had 62. Like 40 and 11. I don't know.
It just keeps getting over the years. It just keeps going up.
Next year.
Whoever he was playing must have been off the fucking papaya. Or Brucey.
Wait, I thought you said it was like,
like
whatever.
Was that the same year that? Like, wait, cause is that the same year TJ nuts. Dropped like 60 for the hour or something like that?
Yeah. That was against Teach too, against Rise.
Damn.
That's why, and I remember saying to Teach, I'm like, bro, like, come on, like your team, you have the superior team here. Like,
run your ship.
Just, come on. Went map 5 to smoke them. Iceman.
Oh wait, that was really against you.
Wait, what did he say? What did Matt say? He said now they're on your shit.
Run your ship.
Come on. He went map 5 to smoke him. Iceman.
Oh, wait, that was really against you?
Yeah,
it was.
Shade?
I was against Rise. At the time, it was
no,
Yuli.
The 61 wasn't.
Oh,
he's talking about the 60s. Hell no. He's not dropping 60 against me.
Yeah, right. That wasn't against me either. I was watching, trust. No. I'm going to shut that shit down instantly.
No, but that was like the old Rise before they got gunless and became like godlike.
Yeah, so
he's like still fellow good at S&D player, Aqua, TJ? And
the... Oh, shit.
He's still good at S&D?
Yeah, he's good.
It's like,
because he still plays the same way. Just like, just chows everything.
Just go fuck.
Yeah. Just runs down mid. So 5-5 is like, fuck it. I'll just go down mid.
Yeah, real quick, guys. If you guys are subbing and stuff, after the podcast, I'll shut you all out because I don't want people watching on YouTube or something to get annoyed. Okay, so this will be the last time. But yeah, I'll shout everybody out. Don't worry.
Who would you say is like the top S&D player? Like, I feel like the individual like playmaking thing, I don't see it as much anymore as like I used to. I feel like I don't know. That could be me. Like,
I don't know. Seth's pretty good search.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna cap. Seth might be the best player.
The best S&D kids are in the league right now, probably. There's no like S&D kids like there were back in the day.
That's what I was thinking. Yeah. That's what I'm thinking.
Like back in the day, like search kids were better than pros, but like now, like all the search kids are in the scene.
Yeah.
That's what I was thinking.
And they play more like pros do now. Like I feel like S&D kids, when you play them back then, like.
They would do
you
like,
would notice their shit. You'd be like, they're a little different.
You know what I'm saying?
A little different. Like you'd zy back.
Now it's really like.
It's so team based. It's like so team based. So you can't be like playing an island and like costing your team.
Right.
You like your team's like getting pushed out and shit.
Dude, I saw
like,
some shit when you guys were playing on raid. I was like, what the fuck? Like both of you guys, only three of you guys hit on both sides, like both teams.
Oh, and Zig?
Yeah. And everyone just dropped. It was like,
yeah,
what
it's
the
like
fuck
a paintball.
That's just the way this game is. And you can't snipe too, which is so like one dimensional how to play the game.
Like not sniping makes this all search so different.
Dude, it adds another element.
Especially that left side.
You feel like you can just chow. So you like take a chow from like top granny, top red on like standoff.
You can swing on every, and like you don't get punished for it. You know what I'm saying?
The whole way you play search is literally different because like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I could tell.
If you're worrying about a sniper, you just play different.
You play more like trying to like stay alive.
You just play like you're playing angles thing. Way tighter. Like
that
you know
is true. You probably feel like the map's open all.
Yeah,
out,
you feel like,
times.
You feel like you feel like yeah. You feel like you could just like shoulder some shit and be like, yeah, there's one deep tree. Let's go somewhere else. Like you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
I don't. Yeah, until you get fucking two bulleted by a fucking Krieg from across the map because that should be happening.
Yeah, like
that,
the scene's gonna be so different. Next season, whenever snipes do come back,
you should just bring it back for champs. Like who cares?
Just for champs.
That'll never happen.
Hey, like. I don't know. We're on land.
I'm playing like, other break GAs. I don't fuck with nobody.
Bro, if I'm a fan, I'm tight that the snipers are GA'd. Because when I used to watch, like back in the day, like I remember watching you guys in IW, like when you used to snipe, or like you and Johnny snipe in that like that one final in IW, that was like lit. I'm like, damn, that was a dope ass snipe.
Yeah.
And then you hear the crowd go crazy. Like that's like
it's
dope.
Such a.
Like, it's like a
little mini game.
Right. Yeah. I feel like I kind of compared it to like dunking in the NBA.
Yeah.
Where it's like it's so like it can be easy. Like if you're pre-aiming something and somebody walks, it's an easy dunk. But you could also just fucking jam on somebody's face. Yeah. Like you know what I mean? Like if you have the snipe
and
they chow
like,
you quick scope them.
And like you would look for it, like whenever S&D was on, I'm like, yo, someone's gonna snipe and then like I'm gonna like watch this 10 minutes from like just for that one snipe. You know what I'm saying? Now it's like S&D's on, like damn, they're just gonna jiggle everything. Like
you know what it is too about sniping, like going back to Davis's point, bro, you can also like for instance, why don't we just GA like multiple snipers? Why don't we just allow one sniper per team? Because if that's the case, if you throw a shimmy and you know this guy's got a fucking sniper, bro, you could go work another part of the map with numbers and probably overtake a squad. Like a sniper can fucking hurt a team too, you know? Like if a sniper's not hitting his shots, and teams are getting used to how to put a sniper at a disadvantage and play around a sniper, it'll hurt the team more than help them. Which is why I don't think sniping is all bad. I think it's just because it's so easy in this game. I think that was like the main problem. It's just so easy where people were just walking around with snipers, just fucking doing whatever the hell they wanted. Which I get that. But, you know, I don't know, adjust like the aim in sight or some shit. I don't know, do it something so where people can't just walk around quickscoping and shit. But like, if people are walking around the map L triggering with a sniper, like, bro, they can hit shots, but for the most part. And then plus, somebody sent the chat two smokes is also a big thing. Like, the smokes are broken, so you can't smoke a sniper out. But I personally think one sniper on the map, you can pretty easily ignore them and do something else.
Yeah, it is like, super like.
It's like, yeah, it's like,
fun to watch.
It's like you take away, you took away snaking and just added jiggling. So it's just, it's kind of like Black Ops 4-ish without the snake.
And I get it, like, why we jaded, because it's like, obviously, this game is kind of broken, but like, we're not, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, the viewers are kind of paying us right now. So, like, we got to entertain them. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, we're not in a position to be greedy, not just for the rest of the game. Like, bro, I'm trying to have a job in 2 fucking years. You know what I'm saying? I'm fucking GA this shit.
So if Snipes, yeah, say, bro, hypothetically, Snipes came back for champs, which one of you guys is running snipe?
Probably him.
Bruce.
Like, I would give it to Matt sometimes, but probably me.
He's being nice. I know him too well, yeah, but it's probably him.
You know, you'd be like, yo, so I'm going to go for this pick right here. I'm like, yo, where do you want me to go for this pick, actually? Yeah, yeah. I'm going to go top, right? I can snipe this guy. Yeah, I got you. I just see you pull a sniper. Nah, but we'd be like the first team with like two, like,
you could
defense.
Run two in this game.
Yeah, for sure.
Have a double off.
I'm like, yo, you got it. I got B.
Yeah, you could. You could run
it's
two.
Like a double
the way the sniper is in this game, you could
totally just put the two subs middle, just rotate based off of.
Yeah.
See, you
are the COVID subs just running up here. Like, yo, we got this shit.
Just contaminated everyone in the same building.
Now they got mid control. They got mid, bro.
They got mid.
Oh, God.
I gave that shit up. What?
What?
You
fucked
that? I did not want to fuck
you. You see all that green shit coming out of them?
Like a viper roll shit. Bro, they're basically viper at that point.
Moscow people.
Like, yo, they mauled me off. Like, I'm literally mollied off. What do you want me to do?
Stay away from checking.
The COVID.
Hello,
subs,
guys.
Bro.
I know you guys have been sticking through the podcast just so you get one stay and pee. Okay. Any of you on straight
at this point? Or you're running?
Right. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Wondering. When is it like?
Probably
that's
like,
a cutoff right there.
Probably like. Or like a hips thing or something.
Yeah, it's like, it's like
if your hips move too much, then like you're considered running.
What are you cha-cha-chaing at that point?
See, look. Look at that. Look at them. Look at them go.
How are you not going to run?
That's jogging.
How are you
what?
That's what I'm saying.
They're basically...
Like, I'm waiting for a little blind spot, and I'm sprinting.
What
you know what I'm saying?
Not they're running.
Bro,
they're
what?
Jogging very lightly. That's not, right? That's not fast walking.
I don't understand. There's got to be...
This is just so unbelievably trolly.
Dude, what? They just look like, yo, you know what it looks
this
like?
Is
they're
so
they're
trolly.
Like at the pool, and then like the floor is like hot as fuck. Like you know what I'm saying?
Lava.
And then like, yeah, shit, yeah. Is it hot? They're just dancing.
Look at him talking shit. He passes him up. He's such a slow, slow motherfucker.
It's all on the hip.
Slow ass walker.
It's like, damn, like amateur not moving his hips.
Oh, that's not.
It really is on the
penalty zone.
It's like, you have to penalty. This guy's running.
Yeah, you're fine. You're running.
It's just crazy. It's crazy that there are people.
How are someone not running in this little pack?
Dude, this is running, bro. Look
guy,
at the guy in the
far right.
You're telling
far
me this
right,
guy's
far
not
right's
running?
Far right's running.
That's a thing, Jack?
Yeah.
Far right's running. Yeah.
You just know that there's people with a gold medal hanging in their home, and then other people come in and like, oh my God, you have an Olympic
there's
gold
like,
medal?
Oh, you that old thing?
Would you be proud of this thing?
That old thing? Yeah, I run shit.
How many, like, what are the comments? I got to know what the comments say. When you eat Taco Bell,
that's what I'm saying. Like, they look like they have a purpose, bro. They're gonna have to wait.
When the lifeguard tells you no running, dude, that is exactly
what
it's
exactly
like.
What that is.
Just like.
Like, Chad, if you fucking tried to speed walk an Olympic speed walker, he'd probably fuck you up. You know what I'm saying? But it's just weird because it's speed walking. Like, it's just like, I don't know. Like, how do you determine that fine line between, like, speed walking and, like, jogging, you know? Like, how do you determine that? You know, it's like, a weird
I'm a
spot.
Fast walk in my life.
It's like, yeah, shit going, like around the, going around the pool.
Wait, so what was the question again?
So, yeah.
Or, like, in the airport? Or, like, in the airport, you know, if you're, like, running in front of people?
Yeah,
you fast walk the fuck out that shit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's really all in the hips.
Because then is. When you see someone running in the airport, you're like, damn.
I'm like, that guy needs to catch that plane.
Late.
Yeah. He needs to catch that plane.
Like, the plane is already...
Like,
it's already
scheduled.
It's
like, why are you
going off? He needs to catch that flight.
Yeah. Exactly. Everybody's
about to be ruined.
Everybody just parts.
Wait, are you guys just waiting? Are you guys just parents the same way where, like, they'll leave to the airport, like, 4 hours early?
Yeah.
Like, we got to get there.
Yeah.
Traffic?
Yeah. I usually leave, like, hour 30 before.
That's what I'm saying. Like, same.
I used to think the same way. Like, I should get there, like, 2 hours before because my parents were, like, conditioning for me for that. But then now I leave, like, 30 minutes before.
Like,
with no, probably, like, 45.
Oh.
Like, when I fly to SNA, it's so quick. Tell them really quick.
I still do that. Like, yeah, my parents, like, even now, my mom, you're going to be late to your flight. I'm like, it's still 3 hours before. She's like, you know how traffic gets. And the line, I'm like, it's only like 15 minutes. Like, yeah. They're just like so
Sometimes that airport line is like, it looks like
it could be a dagger.
It looks like it's going to be like an hour and a half. But somehow, it's
bro, when you pull up, to an airport and like you have to catch your flight and you just see the line, you're like, dude, there's no way.
They swindled me when I got there. I saw the line. I'm like, dude, like you can get clear and skip. I'm like, yeah,
bet. Right? And it's empty. Let me guess,
3 months later, I just get charged $150. Like,
yeah, yeah.
What the fuck? No one told me I got to cancel.
Remember when you skipped that line?
Yeah.
You want to hear a cool story? After Champs Line W, I stayed for like a week and went to Disney World, whatever. And then like, after that, I was flying home, and I show up to the Orlando airport, like, I don't know, it was cutting close already, right? I see that line, even Orlando airport, like, it's just like a little clusterfuck in a corner. Yeah. Like, it's just like, what the fuck's going on?
Dude,
and I
pulled up
and I was like, okay, we're not making our flight, whatever, so, like, I'm gonna look up new flights, whatever. So then this guy comes up to me, taps me on the shoulder, he's like, yo, you wanna try this new clear shit? And I was like, I bet. I mean, like, why the fuck not? And so I'm skipping the line, I'm getting dirty looks from everybody. I'm like, why the fuck am I getting this, right? And because Clear had just came out, and he's like, no, yeah, we're just like doing helping some people out. I get through, right? And we make the flight. But like, as this guy's like sending me off to the security, he just goes, good shit of chance, by the way, formal. That's what I got. And I was like, yeah, you like that shit? I was like, bet. That's good looks. He goes, like, this is so cool.
Dude, that's
it was
crazy.
Super cool.
That's I was like, that's,
it was super cool.
Dude, I forgot about that Orlando airport. It's like you walk it's in and there is no line. It just looks like a cafeteria, school cafeteria.
It's like people just spawned in.
I mean, I don't know about you guys, but I always try and get to the airport 2 hours before. I like getting to the airport early. I just like getting there early. I like eating. I like fucking chilling out, listening to music. Like, it's a vibe. If something fucking happens, like, I think one time something happened where, you know, I couldn't get to the airport in time. So when I got there, I just tossed the guy $100. It's like, I gotta get in front of the line. I'm gonna miss my fucking flight. I don't wanna buy another one. Just, what do I need to do to get to the front?
It's just like there's like eight lines going into one little like cluster.
Like cluster. Just like being everybody's shoved just in, like, dude, I do remember that's how COVID started.
I hate that shit.
Yeah, it started in Orlando.
In that line, Chicago's airport. I hate that one too.
Chicago. Oh yeah.
Really? You don't like that one?
I hate that one. It's always so long. Dude.
Yeah. It's either you get there and there's nobody there you're in, or the line just
I've only been there and it's been packed.
Me too.
Dude, the DFW Hollywood. One is more. I can't stand DFW. Hollywood.
Really?
There's certain airports that have the vibe.
Best vibe.
The North Carolina airport is dope.
I've been there before. That one's really quick.
That one's real nice.
It's nobody lives there.
Best vibey airport.
Well, only the good people live there.
Yeah. Not many good
ones. Dude, when I went to Philly airport, it was a shit show.
Yo, Chad, I have a funny story about that. One time when I was younger, not about the airport, but kind of just like finessing the system, I was at Sports Authority. I don't know if you guys know what Sports Authority is, but I was a kid and I wanted a baseball bat. And, you know, we didn't have much money at the time. And my dad, he picked up, there was this bat that I really liked. I was with my dad. It was me and my pops. We were in Sports Authority looking at all the baseball bats. And there was one baseball bat that was like $300-$400. Like, it was a really nice fucking big ass fucking bat. It was beautiful, nice color, this and that. Fucking my pop, he took this $50 bat and he took the price tag off of it and attached it to the fucking $400 bat and took the put the tag over the fucking barcode, over the $400 barcode. He said, this is the bat you want. This is the bat you're getting. You're getting this shit for $50. Let's go. You know me, I'm a kid, you know, I'm not gonna tell him. I was just, okay, daddy. I just walked him over to the front of the line, and then he bought the bat, and then he opened up the bag. He gave me the bat and all a bunch of fucking candy and shit and all this other shit that he stuck in a bag. I said, dad, you steal this stuff? Listen, my dad was a bad example when I was young, okay? Listen, that's why he did his time. He did his fucking time. He went to prison, okay? He got deported. He did what he had to do.
The Philadelphia airport, that shit was
really? I don't know.
That shit had shit come out of the ceiling.
Just, they don't give a fuck.
Have you ever been to LaGuardia?
Yeah.
LaGuardia is like, bro, it's like a different world. It's like a different world. Like,
Atlanta's is ratchet, dude. There's like, is it? There's like eight smoking sections. Like, in the one Delta wing, I'm just like, I mean, I'll fuck with it, but the like, why are there so many? There's like side by side. Like, I'm like, what the fuck is going on?
The smoking section's insane. It's literally a glass bubble in the middle of the floor. And everyone's in in there smoking. 20 people playing slot machines in a glass room.
With slot machines,
slot machines.
Can't
you gamble as soon as you land?
And people are
gambling. They got like slots and shit.
They got slots inside like
the airport. Yeah, maybe I have seen that.
Hurry, set up.
Yeah,
that's kind of typical.
It's just like smoky in there.
When's the flank? Read the title.
Just like everybody's just sketchy.
You come out like
no one's saying a word. No one's saying. Everyone just has their own little demons and shit. Themselves like, God damn it. This is so weird.
Some people don't even sit at the slot. They'll just tuck in the corner and just.
Right.
The flight was crazy.
Right. They just need a minute.
They just need a minute.
Because that fucking. The baggage claim in Vegas airport is actually like hella mixy. It's like super fucking big. You guys know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
It's fucking massive and it's hard to like, it's just not very like.
There's like, you got it. There's
it's a weird vibe. It's a weird ass vibe. It's a weird vibe.
At their baggage claim.
Yeah. And it's like, yeah. It's like 16 of them just all lined up and you're like, which one am I? Like, it just feels weird. And then
I remember the first time I went to Vegas, I was in that baggage claim area and I was looking at it and I was like, damn, how many people were probably like their life was just ruined here? And that's all I could think about, because that's all I thought about at Vegas is like people picking up their bags and they're just like, I'm about to lose, you know, $100,000.
I can't go into my family. Weekend. I'm better on mortgage. So yeah, I guess I'll just stay.
There's been a lot of like inner convos for sure.
Oh, dude, I bet you some shit has gone down at that Vegas airport.
Yeah.
At every Family's airport, leaving and probably.
Shit. Just like
psychotic shit.
Yeah. I don't know why my mind went there when I landed.
Super weird.
Yeah, so that's anyway, Olympic. Yeah, so if you were to train.
You guys been to Columbus Airport? The one that's been under construction for like 10 years?
Oh, yeah, Columbus.
Every time I go get my bags, I'm like, bro, I swear this fucking thing's been under construction for like forever, dog. Like, forever.
I don't know.
Is that the airport where you're walking through the shoe shine shit is here and then they have the food court to the left before security?
Yeah. It's a Max and Irma's.
Yeah.
Okay. Where's like a Chili's or some shit? Yeah.
Like, that's the one before like MLG events, right?
Yeah, we used to go there all the time.
It's got construction and shit.
I hated that airport. That airport was such bad vibes.
You don't like any airport from what I'm hearing.
Yeah, SNA's vibey. First of all,
SNA?
Yeah, SNA, Santa Ana.
And what about LAX? Yeah. LAX is horrendous.
LAX is horrible.
It's horrendous.
Most airports are horrible. No one likes flying like that. Like, no one's like, dude, I can't wait to go to LAX later. Yeah, let's go 6 hours early. Just chill. Like, no, it's a horrible time.
Yeah, no, literally, fuck LAX.
It's so packed. LAX is so mixy.
Unbelievably packed.
And when you land, you gotta go into a bus to a fucking court where you gotta find a cab to get into.
Bro, it's mixy as fucking LAX, bro.
I've only been to LAX once since they did all that.
Wait till you go this time.
Because it used to be like, you just wait for, and you just see your Uber. You see your Uber all the way over there, just weaving in and out of like stop and go traffic. Yeah. And you're like, it's me, I'm over here.
It's so bad at LAX.
Yeah,
One time I got there, like an hour and 45 minutes before my flight left, right, with my brother. And this, I missed this flight. I missed it because like we were in that little circle thing and that like there's like a, so when you go there like from the freeway there's like a tunnel and then the circle
but
there's a giant tunnel first and like the cars were backed up to behind the tunnel, right? Like I was like, what the fuck? And my other option was like get out and start like running with my suitcase. So I was like, it's not worth that. So, like, I don't need to catch this flight. I kind of want to catch it, but like I don't need to. And then like I just missed it, but I was just thinking to myself like, there's no way this is how this is set up. Like, you know what I'm saying?
That is the best feeling though, like going to the airport like, all right, I know I like kind of need to get on this flight.
But
like, if something goes wrong, I'm not really tripping.
Some people, if they miss a flight, their week is ruined.
They might get fired.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh shit.
Yeah, but then if you're in a situation like that, you're not gonna take any chances. Like, I'm gonna leave 45 minutes before. You know why not? Like, you're gonna be cheating. Unless you're me and you're completely irresponsible and you miss some pretty important flights.
See, I don't like missing flights. I've never missed a flight in my life, chat.
You know what I'm saying? Imagine just
flying private. Like, you don't have to do any of that.
It'd be weird.
That's a different lifestyle.
You'd get way too adjusted to that, and like, you would just never settle for any class.
Way too adjusted.
Even first class was like, what the fuck is this?
First class is the same way, I feel like.
Not as private.
Nah, not as private, obviously, but.
Yeah.
I mean, but once you
flew first, the more I wanted to fly first. If the airport was never packed and you sat in first class, you would get that feeling.
Dude, if Hex
never going through, like,
there's little mixes you go through over the years where you remember and you're like, dude, I hate flying.
That's what you
need. Because, like, you've just been through so many of those little mixes.
That's what you need, like, beats or, like, earbuds to, like, sound. You need to get out of that zen, bro. That zone of, like, that little mix.
I mean, everyone has headphones.
But, like,
the worst is when you get woken up or some shit.
Yeah.
And I'm like, bro, you can put my tray for me? Like, I'm sitting in the aisle, too. You can just do me a solid. Or like I fall asleep and the guy goes, yeah, I gotta take a piss. And I'm like, bro, we just off, dog. Like,
yeah, that's it.
And they pissed like three more times, like an international. And by the end of the flight, I hate the guy. Like, dude, I hate him.
I was on a flight, and the lady, I was basically a free flight. I went to LA, and I'm sitting next to this lady, and I guess like whoever she was with was on the aisle over. But instead of her just saying, excuse me, do you mind? She like called the flight attendant, like, excuse me, is there any way where I could get them switched? And I'm right there. I'm like, and the lady's like, do you mind switching? And I'm like, okay. Like, why didn't you just ask me?
She asked her to ask you?
Like, yeah, like, what the fuck was that? Man,
that's so
I'm
weird.
Not going to lie. I gave up a window for an aisle, so it was a little bit, but I didn't want to be a dick, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you guys enjoy
I'm usually
flight,
pretty man. Flexible with that. Like, if someone asks me for my seat, like, if they're like, let me sit next to my girl or something, flexible. I'm like, yeah, but I don't care. As long as I'm like, putting me in like some like 36B.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. Like, right. Obvious, just, like, just like it's not fair switch at all. you mind if I sit up in first with my girl? It's
my
girl.
You're trying to finesse.
What seat are you in? I'm like 34D, but like, it's the same shit.
It's my girl.
Dude,
no,
I remember,
actually, I can't.
I remember Hex bought me when we went to some sort of like event, Hex was like, yeah, we're going back early. I'm going to get like flight back on like a Virgin airline or whatever, and then we sat first. It was the first time I ever sat first class. I was like, fuck, like I want to do this all the time now.
It's one of those things that once you get it once, like, you're just like, damn, I can't play it.
Dude, once you hit the like,
you know when you feel hella bougie?
Like, you're like, oh my God.
You know when you feel hella bougie is like when you take an international and you fly first and you have your little pod, dude. Bro, and you're sitting there like, excuse me, peasants. I'm going to the left. You guys, yeah, you can talk. She's going to send you down that way? Excuse me. Yeah, I got to go upstairs. You know what I'm saying? Like, and then you're in your little pod like, yeah, I'll take a glass of wine.
First class international.
When we went to the eSports Awards, when Nick took Matt's award, I always have to... When we came back, we flew first. So Nick and I literally just like laid down, like we sat next,
bed, right?
We sat next to each other in the bed. The seats like folded into beds. We were just like sitting down, and we both like synced up the Truman Show and watched it together, and then fell asleep.
That sounds super.
That's
cool.
Romantic.
Yeah. Super
that's beautiful.
Cute.
And then that was the only time.
That's so nice.
Whenever the plane was descending, I was like pissed. Because I was waking. Yeah. I woke up.
There are some times like that.
I had a one vibey flight like that. Where I stayed up for like it was almost 2 days because it was my first time going to London.
No, yeah.
I was
like, I don't want to like
be up the whole time on the flight. It used to be like in the back of my mind, like, fuck, I don't want to stay up the whole time.
Yeah.
Bro, I remember just falling asleep and waking up, and they were like, you're going to be arriving in London Heathrow in like 30 minutes. I'm like,
that's the best.
Yeah.
Did I?
That's the best.
Like when you fall asleep before
and you wake up landing or some shit, that's the best.
Have you ever fallen asleep? Yeah. Have you ever fallen asleep before it takes off?
Yeah.
And you sleep through the takeoff?
Bro, one time.
Psycho, but I've done it multiple times.
Yeah. Listen to this, bro. At IW Vegas, like we had like a really shitty event. We got like eighth or something, but like I ended up getting sick at the end of the event, right? And so I was gonna fly back to LAX, which is like 30-minute flight from Vegas, right? And I get really sick in the airport as my flight's getting delayed all day. This is when like LAX had some shit where like they were really backed up in traffic and it fucked over everyone for like a week. Okay. But this is like the first day. So I didn't know about this yet. This is happening in real time.
Yeah.
So I'm in Vegas airport by myself and it's like 30 minutes go by. They're like, they're doing the shit where they're like delaying it for 50 minutes and just keep doing that all day.
Oh,
and
that's
so like 8 hours later, I'm like sick at this point. Now I'm sick. Right. And I'm like sitting there like in hell, whatever. I finally get on the plane and we take off. I fall asleep. Right. And I wake up and we're landing. So I'm like, thank God, it's almost over. You know what I'm saying? And I get out of the fucking airport or out of the plane. And I'm still in Vegas. And I'm like, what the fuck?
Yo.
Because they turned around midair, right? So I fell asleep when they were taking off. And I'm like, dude, thank God it's over. You know? And I woke up landing in Vegas.
That's like a nightmare.
And I'm like, bro, what the fuck? I'm like, no way, I'm back in Vegas. I was losing fucking full, dude.
You literally can't leave.
I was like, dude, I could drive to fucking LA. Like, I was like, dude, this is so annoying. I was so fucking weirded out.
So something like happened with the plane or something?
No, they just were still backed up at LAX. So they were like, yeah, we thought we could leave, but like I guess they're still backed up. We got to go turn around and wait. And I was like, bro.
Yeah, that's horrible.
I was like, no shot.
I lost composure,
so bad.
Bro.
And I was getting sicker. Oh, it was horrible.
Do you remember the flight to Australia?
Yeah, that was fun as fuck.
How long was that?
It was like 15 hours.
Oh my God.
Bro, we left on
15 hours.
We left on Tuesday.
Such a dagger.
We left on Tuesday and landed on Thursday.
Bro.
Oh, because you guys are, you're also going forward.
Yeah,
because
it's a 16.
That's trippy.
It's a 16-hour flight or something like that.
Wait, what did you say?
You're skipping the Wednesday completely.
I would say like Australia stole Wednesday from me.
Yeah, right. And that 24 hours, anything could happen. No one knows.
They say, yeah, I always say that I've lived every day of my life except for one Wednesday.
Yeah, right.
I remember boarding the flight.
That Wednesday could have been lit.
I remember boarding the plane for that flight. I remember thinking,
no way. I just said no way, and no way just subbed for the 6 months. That just whoa, bro. Whoa.
Like everyone on that flight had the same vibe, like we're about to go through a journey. Strap in. You know what I'm saying? Like everyone eat, everyone take a piss. Like everyone's on that vibe.
Everyone was like that.
Yeah, it's like everyone's ready for a
first class. But then like Hexagon was like, it wasn't like first class. It was like something.
We got business.
Yeah, it was like premium economy or something like that.
I had a pod though.
Yeah, we all had pods.
Yeah, we had pods.
But it wasn't first class.
That must have been cash.
So we like all
you want to go to bed, you're like, good night.
Yeah,
we slowly like turned into a fucking lay down spot.
We like all laid down, and I remember we all slept. I think all of us slept the entire flight.
It on the way back for sure.
Fucking oh, dude, no, not on the way back. On the way there. On the way back, I did not have premium economy, and I sat between two big dudes.
Oh, I still
for 15 hours.
I still had a pod. That sucks.
Yeah, well, you guys were like, you know, sucks. Rich.
Are we out again?
Oh, wait, that was when Hector bought all of us except you, the fucking pod. Yeah. That was like, damn.
It was real bad.
But you were like, sucks. You were going to be like, you can have my seat.
I was going to be like, it's bad enough to where we can switch. But it's pretty bad. No, you're to the right. Yeah, you're the right. I'm going to the left. I'm like, upstairs.
There like wasn't another, there wasn't another premium economy one. The only one was first class, and first class ones were like $7,000.
It was like $16,000.
Yeah, something like that. So Hex was like, you good? And I was like, yeah, I'm good.
Yeah, I'm good. Yeah,
just first 15 hours.
Dude, oh my God.
Damn. I couldn't even sleep. I just watched 4 movies.
Yeah, I watched a lot of movies. I think I watched the whole Lord of the Rings trilogy.
Did you?
On the way there. I think so. Like, I just kept putting on the next movie and just falling asleep and then waking up and being like, oh, this part's lit. And then falling back asleep and shit.
Yeah, I couldn't do that.
I'm like, no, Frodo.
I remember it. I was like, dude, the worst is when a flight doesn't have AC or the AC doesn't work.
Oh, that's a dagger.
Dude.
Because I've had like some of those in the summer. Especially when you're going like somewhere hot.
Yeah, it's happening when we're on the tarmac. They'll be like, we got to turn off the AC for like,
oh, yeah,
you know what I'm saying? And I'm just like, bro, what the fuck?
Everyone's It'll just sweating.
Like, you can feel the difference.
You know what the worst is? Is when you're about to take an international flight, you get your seat and like, you can tell it's about to just be a horrible flight. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you're in like a really mixy ass seat. You're not, you're spread out with like your friends.
You're like a baby crying.
And then you look at the back of the seat and there's no TV and you're like, wait, what?
Ugh.
How is this even legal? Like, I remember flying to London one time and I was just like, bro, what am I supposed to do?
No Wi-Fi, no TV,
nothing. I was like, what am I supposed to do?
That's some psychotic shit.
You're just looking at what? Wi-Fi, no TV. Like,
you're not even, you have the middle, so you can't even look out the window. You're like looking at what? Like the seat in front of you?
I've had some fucking
experiences. So I'm doing state time.
All right, so chat, clearly you guys have seen the NYSL tweet. That was the announcement. I wasn't sure when it was gonna go live. We'll continue this in a. We got 15 minutes left, but for the most part, I think we got through most of it. We got through 50 minutes of it, so we can cut it there. I think they're just gonna bullshit about airport and stuff. I don't see anything else here in the during the watch party. It ends with airport stories, which we've been listening to. So I'm guessing the last 10-15 minutes is just them bullshitting, which is probably hilarious. But I'm just gonna go back and watch this later. But I appreciate you guys tuning in to the Optic Podcast. It's always a pleasure watching these guys.